Hello and welcome to Community Chats. I'm Aley Hammer, and today we're joined with Juliette Murphy, the CEO and co-founder from Floodmapp. Juliette, welcome to the show. Can you start by telling our audience a little bit about Floodmapp?
Thank you so much, Aley, for having me here. It's an absolute pleasure. So at Floodmapp, we're building a safer future. During the recent flood events, there is always so many people that don't have enough warning or understanding of how the flood is going to impact them, you know, the people, the property, the critical infrastructure, especially emergency managers. So we have a very bold vision where in the future, a world in which there's no lives and no damage due to flooding. So we use a mix of traditional flood modeling and cutting edge technology like machine learning and big data techniques to build a super fast, super smart, pinpoint accurate flood model that can be used to predict flooding before the event and in real time. So unlike traditional models, ours works really fast, updates in real time, so that when an emergency hits, we support those emergency managers with intelligence before, during, and after the event. So it means that they have data to know the exact properties to coordinate targeted evacuations or protect sites and assets, and know where recovery funding is needed after a flood event.
Wow. I mean, with recent events, you know, that have occurred in Australia, your business is truly doing a world of good, including saving the lives of so many with your cutting edge technology. And Juliette, I did see in the news recently that you just announced a partnership with Waze and the City of Norfolk, Virginia. That's so cool. Can you share with us how this opportunity firstly came about and also the impact the work is actually having on the citizens of Virginia?
Absolutely. So yeah, we were so excited to roll out Floodmapp's Nowcast model in the city of Norfolk in Virginia. So Norfolk, it's a small coastal city that floods regularly, like every month. You know, even small amounts of rain can cause inundation just due to the sinking kind of city, sea level rise, you know, inundated stormwater infrastructure. So the city is really not able to cope with big rainfall events. Sometimes they get tidal flooding even on sunny days. And so the city is really needing to now adapt to a changing climate and these rising sea levels. And in light of that, there's an agency, a not-for-profit, Rise Resilience Innovations, who are working with innovative technologies, seeking out businesses who are working on coastal resilience and adaptation technology to help commercialize those ideas, working in partnerships with the cities like City of Norfolk. And so they put out a global call for technology that was able to help community members navigate around flooded roads. And so Floodmapp responded to that call. And we were fortunate to be awarded and receive funding through this program, selected to implement our technology as a solution to their flooding. And so we worked with the city collaboratively. And we also worked with Waze, the traffic routing solution, to integrate our technology with Waze to help the public then get essentially alerts so that they can know how to navigate around the flooding in real time as it's happened. And the impact to the community has been incredible. So we've seen hundreds of thousands of flood alerts go out through Floodmapp, you know, Nowcast, which predicts flooded roads. And we've seen thousands and thousands of interactions with the public who's, giving thumbs up to confirm if that, flood alert is accurate, which helps us continually improve that model. Given that, in the recent Australian floods, we saw the majority of lives were lost on flooded roads, and the same in US, up to 200 lives per year are lost on flooded roads. So there's big safety implications for this kind of technology, and really just helping improve the day-to-day quality of life to improve time. You know, if people need to know when to pick up the kids from school or when to get to work, this technology is going to help them do that.
So cool. The partnership with Waze is so impressive and so impactful. And Juliette, moving on from this a little bit, why did you choose to invest in the cloud, and in particular, I guess, AWS?
Yeah, so from day one, we knew we had to build a cloud-based company. I think part of the challenge we're solving with these real-time models is that traditional flood modeling technologies have always been very computationally intensive, just due to the amount of data pouring into them and the complex physical equations that are going into this. So we knew cloud was a must, and AWS really supported us from day number one. In the early days, we went into a startup accelerator, and we were able to get access to some programs there with some credits. So, you know, our kind of engineering team was really proud to sort of partner with a company that has a lot of experience in keeping data safe, maintaining, you know, service reliability and availability, that were willing to kind of work with us collaboratively, you know, no matter where our staff are in the world. Mm-hmm. So, you know, we work with emergency management, so we needed a service that had that, you know, reliability, the trusted brand, the available kind of redundancy to serve those emergency management with confidence during the flood event. So yeah, so AWS was really a perfect fit, and it's been incredible kind of going on the journey with them from when, you know, we sort of were just working out how to do a simple kind of computation to now sort of, you know, running thousands of services across kind of thousands of machines in real time. And that's kind of growing every month. So that scalability is quite incredible.
Of course. I mean, most companies seek out a partner who's reliable and secure, but in your field, it's so imperative that your partners can deal with emergency flood events. So I'm really glad that we haven't let you down in those difficult times. And Juliette, I know your team has worked really closely with our AWS startup team that you've just mentioned along your journey. So, you know, you mentioned credits and things like that, but how has the experience been working with our startup team specifically?
So yeah, really amazing. I guess one of the amazing things about AWS is that it was born from a startup. So I think inherently AWS gets startups, and in more ways, you know, than maybe other companies understands that. So Amazon, you know, they're a global giant now, but I guess the thirst to create something new is still there. And so it's been incredible kind of working with the team in some, you know, hackathons and prototyping programs to explore all the different ways that we can use AWS, and that AWS can, you know, develop sort of and improve, you know, future services. So we use the AWS kind of forecasting service to experiment how that can help us better run machine learning experiments for new types of models. And yeah, they've been really supportive in just helping us explore what's possible, I guess.
Well, I love that you guys remember this about AWS, because yes, of course, you're right. And, you know, to say that thirst to create and innovate will never leave us is so true. Everyone wants to be in that startup team at AWS and you know, help companies build and innovate. So you're absolutely right. Juliette, to round up this interview, I did want to ask you, what are some future technologies that you're excited about that will actually help the work that Floodmapp's doing?
Great question. So yeah, I don't know. We're so excited for the future in general. We recently just announced, we raised a seed round of AU $8.5 million led by New York-based Union Square Ventures. And this money is just vital for us as we grow. So we're investing in product, we're investing in scale, we're investing in our go-to-market, to really build and strengthen our technology in two geographical markets, Australia and the US. So we have a product, we know it works. It works as a direct feed into GIS systems for emergency managers and as an interface to, you know, traffic apps. But the more that we improve our models, and the more that we're able to sort of scale that technology, the more we can work with new sort of industry verticals and sectors. So we work a lot with governments right now, but we're hoping to work with more, you know, critical infrastructure agencies, transport agencies, within more countries. So the future, we really want to do a lot more with machine learning and how we introduce that to solving the problem of hydrology forecasting. And we want to put this technology into more hands of more emergency managers and communities to build a safer future.
Thanks so much, Juliette. I mean, in light of all the recent floods in Australia, your business value has definitely been felt very close to home. Before, you know, a couple of months ago, I wasn't aware of how many floods were happening all the time, right in my backyard, you know, so it's really crazy. It's such an impressive business. Your impact's remarkable, and you should be so proud again on the seed round. So congrats. We cannot wait to continue working with you. And if anyone has any questions, please pop them in the comment section below and we'll get back to you. Thanks so much.